fellow students, today we are going to start a new chapter, dual nature of light wave. Okay, so what is the dual nature? I have already actually told you that in wave optics also, but still I am going to explain you again what is the dual nature. So dual nature of light is nothing but only there are two types of nature it contains. First is wave nature and second is particle nature. As you know that de Broglie already observed dual nature for the matter particles, means electron, proton, neutrons also behaves, they are all particles as you know that. But if they they makes any transition from higher energy level to lower energy level, then definitely there will be emission of wave, means they also possess a wave. A wave is also associated with the motion of them. Means if any particle, matter particle is stationary, then it behaves like a particle. Then and when it is in motion, then a wave is always associated with it. That was the concept of de Broglie, and according with the help of that concept, we have explained so many phenomena of atomic and nuclear physics. So the same problem arises in the case of light waves. So as you know that there are so many phenomena which have explained already with the help of light waves, like reflection, refraction, interference, polarization, and there are so many phenomena, Doppler effect. You can always explain these phenomena with the help of wave theory easily. But there are also so many phenomena with light possesses, and we can't explain that phenomena with the help of wave nature, like photoelectric emission, Raman effect, Compton effect, so etc. So these were the phenomena which were explained on the basis of particle nature, means it is assumed that light also possesses particle as well as wave nature, and they are complementary to each other. Means if we need to explain any phenomena by wave theory, then we will consider light as a wave, and if we will we have to explain any phenomena with the help of particle nature, then definitely we have to consider light wave as particle nature. And what is the complementary thing that from that instrument through which you know light is you are using wave theory of light, then definitely from that instrument you can't ever do measurement of the particle nature. Means an instrument which is used for the measurement of particle nature can't be used for the measurement of wave nature of light. Means we have to make some complementary experiment for the both of the nature. So this is the basic theory of the dual nature of light wave, and it was observed by the Planck. The idea of Planck was that light is made up of so many numbers of photons, and each photon have energy h nu, where h is Planck constant and nu is frequency of light wave. Simple. Means light waves are also consisted with the help of particles, as the matter particle, because matter is also consists of so many types of particles, electron, proton, neutron and others. So that's why as the analogy, you can put an analogy with the with atomic physics and also this wave optics, optical physics. So it means that simply to explain the whole phenomena of light waves, we need two nature of light wave, which is particle nature and wave nature. And I have already told you the history of this and who explained these phenomena. So as you know that wave nature is explained by Huygens, एंड पार्टिकल थ्योरी वॉज गिवन फर्स्टली गिवन बाय न्यूटन, बट ही वॉज अनेबल टू प्रूव एनी फिनोमेना ऑफ रिफ्लेक्स एंड रिफ्रैक्शन एट दैट टाइम विद द हेल्प ऑफ पार्टिकल नेचर. एंड आफ्टर इवन मैक्सवेल प्रूव दैट लाइट इज एन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव, तो आफ्टर सो दैट द थ्योरी ऑफ न्यूटन्स फेल्ड. बट when Planck gave his revolutionary idea about the quantum physics and Einstein used that formula for the explanation of photoelectric effect, then from that time a new revolution comes into the field of physics, and now we know that quantum physics is used, we use quantum physics in every field, and still we are going to use quantum physics at some low scale, like at nano scale and other scales. Okay, so basically now in this chapter we are going to study particle nature of light, and we are going to study the phenomena which we are explained by UG, particle nature, just like photoelectric effect and others. Okay, so let's start here. So to understand the theory of photoelectric emission or photoelectric effect, firstly we have to know what is the free electron model of matter. So as you know that what is free electron or valence electron, if we can know what is the valence electron of any atom, like after electronic configuration the last subshell is called as valence subshell, valence cell, and the electron present in that cell is called valence electron. As we know that after going output to the nucleus, then continually force going to decrease, force of attraction of nucleus is going to decrease. It means the outer electrons are loosely bound electron, but they are not means they can move throughout within the surface of the this, like this, within the surface of this atom, but they can't go outside to the surface of this atom, because as suppose that this electron escape from here, as it escape from here, then definitely this atom will acquire some positive charge, and due to this positive charge there will be attraction force established between this electron and positive charge, and obviously due to this attraction force this positive charge again pull it back to the this atomic surface. So definitely there will be a potential barrier. This positive charge is act as a potential barrier for the free electron, for the loosely bound electron. It is called free electron because it's free to move within the surface, but it is also loosely bound. It can't be totally free, it can't escape through the surface because of this positive negative charge attraction. So this means that there is a formation of potential barrier for this electron. And if this electron we want to free this electron, then definitely we have to add some energy to overcome this potential barrier. Clear? Simply, we have free electrons or loosely bound electrons in every atom, and if we want to make free to them, then definitely we have to add, we have to overcome this potential energy, this potential barrier, by adding some energy which will be equal to the energy of this potential barrier, so that electron can easily get free from here. So this is the free electron theory of metal. And one more concept is here, work function. So I have told you that if we want to make an electron free, then definitely we have to add some energy which must be equal to this potential barrier. So the minimum energy required to escape for electron is known as work function of that metal. Means minimum, how much energy we are needed to make one electron free to make one electron free from this surface and to overcome this potential barrier, then definitely that energy is called work function. So work function helps us to know how much energy we are needed for the electron emission, and if we want electron emission, if we want current, then definitely we have to make escape of this electron. So we have to add energy from the outside. Then how much energy we are needed? So for example, we need 2 electron volt energy to make this electron free, and we are using 10 electron volt. It means that work can be done by 2 electron volt, but we are using 10 electron volt. Means in this case, we are using 8 electron volt excess energy. So there is no need of that excess energy, only need of 2 electron volt to escape this, for the escaping of this electron. So work function helps us to know this type of things so that we can save our energy, we can save our so many means we can, from that electron emission can take place. So we can save easily our energy by using this, and also we can know that how much energy we are needed if we want current, if we want the electron emission, and so on. So I think this is clear. And the unit of work function is electron volt. This is unit of work function. And work function is greatest for platinum and lowest for cesium. So as you know that work function is greatest, it's nearly 5 point something and it's nearly 2 point something. So if the work function is of platinum is greatest, it means that to make one electron free from this surface, then we need to add more energy than in case of cesium atom. Simply, I think this is clear to you. Simple. Then we can easily find the energy and relation through this concept of work function. Then how much energy we are needed, and which metals can be used to for the electron emission, means which metal can give electrons at lowest energy, at lower energy, then we will use that metal for our electron emission process. Okay, so now let's learn the how many types of electron emissions are there. Means by means we are using for the electron emission, like we can also overcome this potential barrier by adding heat energy. We can expose some light on the metal surface for the electron emission. We can also apply a strong electric potential for the electron emission. So and also we can pass some fast moving electron. So after collision, this electron can escape from this. So there are so many types of the electron emission, and that depends on the means we are using for the electron emission. We are using the at the energy. So let's see what is that. So as I was talking about electron, the types of electron emission means the types of means we are using to add energy to overcome the potential barrier. So there are basically of 4 types. First is thermionic emission. So what is the thermionic emission? By name it is clear that we are using thermal energy to overcome the potential barrier. Means if we add some heat energy to the metal so that the bound electron or free electron can escape from the metal surface, and we can get some electrons outside the surface, then that types of emission or process is known as thermionic emission, and the electron emitted are known as thermions. Clear? And the number of electron emission depends on the temperature of the metal. Second is photoelectric emission. So by name is it is clear that this is photo, means we are using photons for the electronic emission. Means if we expose light on the metallic surface of suitable frequency, we are saying suitable frequency because it must be greater than the work function of the metal. So if we apply the simply the light of suitable frequency, then definitely due to that energy there will be the emission of electrons takes place, and the such types of process is known as photoelectric effect, and the electrons emitted are known as photoelectrons. This process we are going to study also in this chapter. So number of electron depends in this process on the intensity of light wave we are using. Okay, third is field emission or cold cathode emission. If we will apply potential difference of nearly 10^8 volt meter, then at this quite high electric potential strength, there is the emission of electrons takes place from the cathode. And as we know the case of X-ray emission, so the experiment of X-ray, so in this case, in that case we used this types of process, then we use a high strength potential applied to the cathode and between the cathode and anode, and that's why there was the emission of electron takes place from the cathode surface or metal surface. Okay, so such types of electron is called field electron or field emitted electrons, the cathode electrons, normal electrons you can also say that. Next is secondary emission. So what is the secondary emission? Like if there are so fast moving electrons, and if they collide to any bound electrons or the collide from the free electrons, then definitely they will transfer some of their kinetic energy to that electron, and definitely that kinetic energy will help to overcome the potential barrier, and again after collision the electron, the free electron can easily escape from the metal surface, and we will get some electron emission. So this types of electron emission is called secondary emission, because we use primary moving electrons to make escape of the secondary electrons. Okay, so these are the basically process of electron emissions in which we are using different types of energy for the electron emission. Okay, so in this chapter, as we are studying about the nature of light, so we will use photoelectric emission. So the next topic is what is the photoelectric emission, and before that I will tell you what is the how many scientists have worked on it. Before Einstein, there were a lot of scientists who worked in this field, like Hertz, Hallberg, Leonard, and so many scientists were worked there. But Einstein explained this phenomenon on the basis of quantum theory, so that he explained law of photoelectric emission and so on. So for that he also got Nobel Prize. So let's see what is the photoelectric emission, what is law of photoelectric emission, and on which factors the emitted electrons depends on. So this types of all process I am going to explain you. So let's start. So now let's study about the photoelectric emission. As I told you, what is photoelectric emission? If any metallic surface is exposed by radiation of suitable frequency, then we get electrons. Emitted by that metal surface or current in external loop, then this types of effect is known as photoelectric effect, or emission is known as photoelectric emission, and emitted electrons are known as photoelectrons. So firstly I'm going to explain you why electrons are emitted through the metal surface when we exposed it by the light. So for that we must know what is the idea of Planck, what is the Planck quantum theory. As you know that Planck gave his quantum idea that electrons are light waves are made up of so many photons, and each photon have energy एच न्यू मीन्स द एनर्जी ऑफ फोटोन इज इंटीग्रल एंड वी कॉल वन फोटोन एज वन क्वांटा एंड ईच क्वांटा हैज एनर्जी ऑफ एच न्यू. ओके, सो इफ अ फोटोन हैज एनर्जी ऑफ एच न्यू देन लेट अस कंसीडर दिस इज अ मेटालिक सरफेस एंड देर आर सो मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स यू नो ऑलरेडी. सो इफ वी विल एक्सपोज इट बाई अ सुटेबल फ्रिक्वेंसी मीन्स फ्रिक्वेंसी ग्रेटर दैन द फ्रिक्वेंसी ऑफ वर्क दिस मेटालिक सरफेस और एनर्जी मस्ट बी ग्रेटर दैन द वर्क फंक्शन ऑफ द मेटालिक सरफेस. सिंपल इफ वी विल अप्लाई एनर्जी ग्रेटर दैन द वर्क फंक्शन मीन्स वी कैन ईजली ओवरकम द पोटेंशियल बैरियर एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन इमिशन कैन टेक्स प्लेस. So when we exposed light of suitable frequency then definitely it will strike to the electrons of metallic surface. Okay. So after striking it one photon gives its complete energy to this electron and after getting that energy electron can overcome the potential barrier and easily escape from that surface and we got a free electron which is as in the form of current or other things. So this is the theory of photoelectric effect that if we expose any metallic surface by light then definitely photons since light is made up of a large number of particles which is called photons and each photons gives its whole energy to the electrons and don't think that photon gives it half energy if electron is needed half energy to just escape from the metallic surface. No, it always gives its whole energy to the electron. If that energy is equal to the work function, then just electron will escape out. But if it is greater than the work function, like if the work function is 1 electron volt and we have applied 5 electron volt energy, then definitely this 4 electron volt energy is used to accelerate this electron, means to increase the velocity of electron, to increase the kinetic energy of the electron. Simple. Means if there is a excess of energy electrons has gained, then definitely some of the its energy will use to overcome the potential barrier and some of the energy will use to accelerate the electrons so that it can easily go to the plate we are using to collect these electrons. Okay, so clear. So this is the concept of photoelectric emission and the emitted electrons are known as photoelectrons, you have already know. The first experiment was proposed by Hertz. Actually Hertz was doing practical an experiment on electromagnetic wave, but while doing that experiment he was using an emitter plate means which electrons were emitted. At that time one more thing is that electron was not discovered till that time. In 1887 Hertz was actually doing that experiment and he observed that a high voltage spark is produced in the detector plate when the emitter plate is exposed by ultraviolet radiation by using an arc lamp. So actually he observed this phenomena of photoelectric emission, but he was unable to explain it because the electron was not discovered yet, and he didn't know at that time that what types of particles are emitted when we are exposing light on it. So that's why he was fully unable to explain that thing. And also at that time, you know that Planck concept was not there, so he was totally unable to explain it, but he observed first that. After that, Halbach and Lennard, two scientists were there, and they did so many experiments on that from the time of 1888 to 19. Means they gave their lot of times on this photoelectric emission or photoelectric effect, and also they observed so many relationship of photo emitted electrons with intensity of radiation, with the kinetic energy, with potential difference. So what is the relation, what is dependency of electron emitted electrons on these three quantities, the three or four things. So they observed it, they explained it after the discovery of electron in 1897 by Thomson. So the what is the experiment of Paul Bosch? Actually they did experiment they used an evacuated chamber, and they put the two plates, metallic plates there, and they observed that when they are using high potential to the this evacuated chamber, no current is flown. Means there is no flow of current through the throughout the circuit. First, when it is exposed by some ultraviolet radiation, then there was the flow of current, and it can easily detect by the by using galvanometer. And so they observed that when metallic surface is exposed by some radiation, then we are getting current. But when it is not exposed by metallic surface, then again the flow of electron stops. So actually I'm always saying flow of electron, but in starting when they also don't know about electron, because electron was discovered in 1897. After that they were able to explain their whole experiment, their whole observation, because aaj you can understand what was the importance of the discovery of electron this field also. So this was the experiment of Paul Bosch and Lenard, and also they connected the emitted electron or emitted current, which we known as photoelectric current, with the means they find out what is the variation of photoelectric current with the potential difference. Means if one plate is obviously this will be negative and positive, and when we expose light on this negative plate, then there is a emission of some some particles. And obviously you know that it's if it's metal, then definitely there will be the emission of electron, and this was attracted to this surface positive plate, and definitely there will be the flow of current due to the completion of the circuit. Okay, so this is clear I think to you, and I will explain you in the experimental observation then what was the variation of electric photoelectric current with the intensity of light, with kinetic energy. That means how can its kinetic energy increase, and what is the difference on this potential. Means if we will change this potential, negative potential or positive potential, then definitely there will be change in the photoelectric current. So and also the metal we are using, definitely if we will use alkali metal, then there will be different electric current. Then and also if we are using some other metals, then definitely there will be some means value of electric current varies with the metal we are using. So these are four concepts upon which electric currents depends on. Then let's see that with an observation. So I think this is clear. And one more thing I want to tell you, alkali metals means first group in periodic table, like sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium, they give photoelectric emission by using visible light simply. And if metals like magnesium, zinc, cadmium we are using, then they give photoelectric emission by using ultraviolet light. Reason is that I've already told you, we need suitable frequency to overcome the potential barrier, and definitely for alkali metal suitable frequency lie between lies for visible light, and also for magnesium, cadmium, zinc types of metals suitable frequency is for ultraviolet radiation. So that's why we use that. So let's see what is the experimental observation for the photoelectric current.